And now we will learn how to bill tenants for shared utilities. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Examples of shared utility costs are all tenants are under the same electric meter, the cable internet is paid by the landlord for the whole building, or water could even be billed under one meter. Why is it billed differently than repair or cleaning? Well, in this case, there's no specific event or service date that you wrote a check for. There is no specific check or bill that you can put on a tenant's invoice, like we did when we did repair and cleaning bill to the tenant. So what can you do? Well, if you agree with the tenant of the amount of utility charge that will be added to their monthly invoice, then you can create an item on the items list that will be added to the monthly rent invoice. And that item will be for that tenant's share of the utility. So remember we talked about the items list. We said, look, if you earn the monthly rent and you put that item on an invoice, the income account, rental income earned, should increase. And we even learned another example of items. If you put a late fee on an invoice, then the account in the chart of accounts that should increase is income from late fees. Well, then doesn't it make sense that if you put an electric charge on the invoice, that the account that should increase for that item should be income from electricity? Well, you could. You could put another income account called income from electricity, and then when you put the utility charge on the invoice, you can make that account go up, if you want. But if you do it that way, you would have to subtract out what you actually paid for electricity as an expense for the whole building in order to determine your real electricity cost. So that's not the proper way to do it. What is the proper way to do it? Well, instead of having the item connected to income from electricity, which is not right, you should instead have the item be connected directly to the electricity expense account, the main one. This way, when you pay electricity for the building, it goes up, but then when you charge the tenant the electric expense, it will decrease the overall electric expense at the moment you charge the tenant. So you might remember that it's the cogwheel in the top right that has all the lists and permanent information. We click and we go over to the column where it says lists, and the second one down is products and services. Now, this is the items list that we dealt with before at the beginning of the course to set up. We have rent due and late fee. Now click right on the word new. And then, of course, when it asks you what type of product, you'll click service. Now, the name will be electricity share, because what you type in here is the way it will show up and look on the invoice. So you want the person to know that it's that tenant's share of electricity. But the account it's connected to will not be an income account in this case. In this case, this item will be connected to electricity expense. And when we put this item on the invoice, our expense goes down because the tenant's balance will go up. And let's make it $25 for everybody. Everybody gets charged with their monthly rent $25 for their share of electricity, and we're going to put that on the rent invoice. So we click save and close, and now we have electricity share for $25 added to the items list. And now let's look at an example. Let's imagine on April 15th, we paid the whole Meadow Lane building electric bill to Con Edison $100 for the whole building. and Con Edison is the electric company out here in New York. So that's pretty easy. We go back to QuickBooks Online, and then of course we click the plus sign for any type of transaction, and then we go over to vendors and we click check, because we're writing a check. Now, the date we're writing the check is April 15th of 2019, and we're writing the check to Con Edison because they're the electric company out here in New York, and that's all we have to do. The category is the account. So click directly under the word category to bring the pull-down arrow, click on the arrow, and then click electric expense, because it's our building, it's our company's electric expense. Here it is. Do not put a customer, do not mark as billable, because this is the electricity for the whole building, and the amount is $100. Now, when we click save and close, we can click reports, trial balance, and you can see that electric expense shows up for the first time on the trial balance as $100. And that's the electric expense of the whole company. Now, on April 30th, we gave Betty the April 30th rent invoice, and we're going to add the $25 electricity charge for Betty's share of the electricity. So, we do what we normally do. We click sales, invoice, and we're going to make a new invoice just like we learned. And the date this time is April 30th, and the customer is Betty Boop. Okay, and now we know that Betty's rent is $1,000, so we clicked product or service, click the arrow, and click rent due, and we know her normal rent due is $1,000. But on the next row, below rent due, we click the next row, click the pull down arrow, and then click electricity share. Now notice, QuickBooks Online remembered that electricity share for everyone is $25, because that's the way we set it up. We can't set up the rent due to come up with the correct amount, because that's going to be different for each tenant. But if the $25 is going to be the same for each tenant, we can leave that set up with the item. And now the total invoice for May is $1,025, broken down this way. And when we click save and close, we can go back to the reports and go to trial balance. Now notice, electric expense has gone down. Our general company electric expense has gone down by $25, because Betty is responsible for that $25 charge. If we click reports and we click transaction list by tenant, you can see here's Betty. Here's the invoice for April 30th. Here it is. And the invoice is not $1,025. It's not $1,000, it's $1,025. So that $25 adds to her balance. And you could also click reports, and you can click tenant balance detail. And you can see that Betty's balance has increased not by $1,000, it went up by $1,025, because that other $25 is her shared electricity expense.